Hey everybody, I'm back again with another video. This is an upgrade of an Aspire E15574G. So here's what you need. An SSD hard drive. I chose a Samsung 500GB. You're also going to need some RAM. I got 8 gigs of Crucial RAM. An external CD-ROM or DVD drive if you don't want to download the software from the internet. A small screwdriver. And an external USB 3 SSD hard drive connector. That's just for doing the cloning. You can get those connectors pretty cheap at any electronics store. So first let's install the software, Samsung's migration software, and just go through the standard steps of installing it. Afterwards, it will give you the option to do an update to that software. I just do the update because I want to get the latest and greatest, but if you just installed it from the CD, it's fine. So I launched it. It's going to say you want to update. I will say go ahead and update. Once again, if you don't want to update, you can skip that step and it will just run off of the original installed software. Tech tip. So whenever you're doing a cloning of a hard drive, you want to select a source and a target, and the source must be smaller than the target. I had a 300 gig written to the hard drive already, so it took 6 hours to complete. Once that's completed, you can go about taking it apart and getting to the hard drive and the RAM locations. You are going to want to have a small can or a cup, something to put all of these screws in. They're very small, easy to lose, and there are a lot of them. I counted over 20 screws. I definitely had to speed up this video because it took a little while to get this thing off, because after you get the 20 screws off, then you have to proceed on cracking the shell. And by the battery is the easiest start point that I found. I had to spin it around and just kind of do it in a circular motion, taking my time not to break the enclosure because the plastic is quite brittle. And then once you get all of the screws off and all of it cracked open, then release the jumper. There's only one jumper holding the backplate on. Now that you have the motherboard exposed, you can click in the RAM. It's an easy process of just sliding it in an angle and pressing down. Okay, now we can move on to installing the new hard drive. So the old hard drive is just sitting in there with the connector holding it in. And you just have to tilt it up and just wiggle it out. We'll set that aside. It is a Western Digital 1TB drive, so I'm going to save that for later and put that in my hard drive caddy, which I also purchased for this upgrade. I will leave the links in the descriptions on everything I used in this video. As easy it is to install the hard drive, just wiggle it right in, and we can now proceed on installing the hard drive caddy. Now, to install the hard drive into the caddy is pretty simple. You just have to angle the hard drive once you've removed its little rubberized shock protection, and you just have to put it in at a slight angle and then wiggle that in and drop it down into the caddy. There it is, and it's all done.
Tech tip.
Now don't forget that there's a small little clip where the screw is going to go into after you get your rear cover on. So you just have to take that off of the old insert and replace it onto the new caddy. and be sure to check orientation to make sure that it's faced in the same direction as the old insert. Okay, now just re-plug in the jumper from the back plate and do a quick once over, making sure that everything is plugged in and seated, including the RAM and the hard drive. Everything looks good, so you can cover it up. Now, I am not going to replace all the screws just yet or even snap it together because I want to do a check and make sure that the hard drive is recognized and the RAM is recognized before I decide to close the enclosure. So after I hit the power button, it comes to this warning that basically said that the boot drive has changed and would I like to proceed, and I just click enter, and then I have to select the boot drive, and it does show my SSD, so I select that in my boot manager as my primary boot drive. So now it's booting up into Windows. And that was pretty fast for a first boot on a new hard drive. So now that I'm in Windows, I'm going to double check and make sure that my RAM is being recognized. Okay, so looking at the system information, I do see that there is 16 gigs of RAM installed. All right. Time to shut down and install the hard drive caddy. I wanted to use this extra hard drive for all of the data storage. This is actually my son's laptop, and he uses it for creating music and creating videos, and so he uses a lot of storage. So that 1 terabyte is definitely going to be utilized. And everything went really good so far in the upgrade until this point. Because I really didn't have a lot of instructions with the HD Caddy, I assumed it was like a server hot swappable drive would be, and that the tracks would guide the connector and make good contact. This was a wrong assumption because it actually did not line up perfect. And even though I tried to press it in there, it was just binding and not sliding in correctly. And when I pushed it even harder, it felt like something moved. And so I thought maybe it went in the actual slot, but this was a wrong assumption. So I decided, unfortunately, that I would put some of the screws back in and go ahead and give it a final test. And that was a bad idea, again, because the touchpad was not working correctly and there was a slight bow in the keyboard.
Tech tip.
I then took it apart and realized that it was not plugged into the connector, it just moved the connector back a little. So I decided to take it all apart and plug it in the right way. And once you've plugged it in, you have to make sure the end cap is off. When the end cap off, the cover can now be placed over it, and it actually goes on really easy. So you just have to plug in your wire once again from your back plate, and once that's in there, you can proceed to close it. So once you get that little connector back on, which is a bugger, but you just got to be gentle with it. Then you can snap it together and give it another go of a test. As you can see, I still have the end cap off, and that is where the last three screws I'm going to put in go. Let's proceed to do the test. I'm going to plug it in and power it up, and let's see how fast it boots. And it took about 6 seconds to boot into the Windows login screen. Everything looks good still. The touchpad is still working. And now I'm booting Windows. And it booted another about 6 seconds, and the touchpad is still working great. I'm going to switch to a mouse just to make it a little bit quicker for the video. Okay, so now that everything is tested, I'm going to finally put the end cap after replacing all of those screws. And it goes right in, and it looks perfect. Okay, so now it's time for the final test. And there it goes. It should be booting right about now. And now I'm going to log into Windows one last time. Okay, that booted really fast. Let's see if my RAM still shows up. Go to system information. And yes, I have 16 gigs of RAM installed. Get her done. Now, I did install the hard drive Caddy, and it does recognize that I installed the hard drive, but the hard drive has to be reinitialized and I have to reformat the drive. Now, I could have used this drive as a backup drive in case my SSD ever went bad, but SSDs last a long time and I'm not really worried about it. So now I'm going to try a game that my son has on this laptop, just to see if it moves fluid, if there's any kind of lagging involved. Now, I know that video cards determine how well a game plays, but, you know, just to see if the hard drive and the RAM affected the gameplay at all. And it seems to be running pretty good. Now, this is a budget laptop. You know, you can do some gaming on it. You know, I wouldn't be putting Crysis 3 full blast on it, but it's a really good budget laptop that can do some, you know, pretty decent gaming and is perfect for anybody, you know, who needs a lightweight, good laptop for school or to edit videos. It works great for that. It's got a 940M in it. Anyway, I would recommend this to a friend in a drop of a hat. It's a great laptop for anybody who doesn't want to spend more than like $500 or $600. And it's really easy to upgrade once you figured it out. So thanks for watching my video. If you liked it, subscribe or leave a comment. And thanks for watching. Keep it real.